Yep, school safety presentation.
I was asked by Mr. Hodges at last month's meeting to just address what some of our practices are in terms of school safety presentation, and I've prepared a narrative I want to read through just to make sure I hit everything. But I hope that we can put the public and parents particularly at ease in terms of the safety threats and concerns, and then also our response and the way we're planning for that. So if you'll indulge me, I'd like to read this just to give a background and some ideas to those who are here and those who may be listening in terms of our responses. We are shocked, saddened, and angered by the senseless acts of violence that we see too often in our world. When the acts are in schools, it brings the threat closer to us. But even when the violence is in a shopping mall, outside in a public area, a movie theater, or inside a home between two family members, the results are still devastating. The debate will go on about what to do to stem these acts, but as those debates rage, we can't stop and wait for a solution. We must go on about our business while working hard to ensure the safety of our students, staff members, and others who are on our campuses to conduct school business. We will work to be a part of the solution, and we believe that starts by having a proactive stance rather than waiting to offer a reactive response. Each school in our system regularly conducts drills throughout the school year. These drills are for fires, weather threats, and other threats on our campuses. The drills are designed to help those in our schools know what to do in the event of a real situation. The drills also allow us to review our response and find ways to improve. We are fortunate to have the support of law enforcement and other emergency responders in our county and in the towns that we serve. We include law enforcement and other emergency responders in our drills to provide feedback and to help ensure that we are following the appropriate protocol in our readiness and response work. Immediately following a drill, a debriefing session is held to address the event and to seek opportunities to improve. I want to stress that we feel that including the emergency responders in our drill activities is beneficial in many ways, but perhaps an advantage that goes unseen is their presence in our building, which helps them become more aware of the unique physical characteristics of each building. The more we have the individuals on our campuses during non-emergency times, the better prepared they will be to carry out their official duties, knowing our campuses well inside and out. Even on a regular school day, when there's no crisis or no drill, we seek to be ever vigilant as we assess our surroundings every day, looking for potential threats. We are quick to respond to something that is out of the ordinary. We do not want to operate in a constant state of fear, but we believe that we must never become complacent about safety in our work. We have a system of communication that we would utilize if needed to alert parents and guardians of an issue at one of our schools. This system would contact every contact number that we have associated with the child. We would continue to follow up with notifications as warranted. If a school goes into a lockdown, we want the public to know that access to the campus is restricted, and this is done to allow emergency responders to deal with the immediate threats and needs at the school. No movement is allowed inside the building or on the school campus during that time. Once the situation is stabilized and the threat is over, the specific situation is analyzed and a determination is made as to what to do with the students. Parents and guardians would receive instructions on how dismissal would be handled and how they could pick up their children or their child. I want to stress the value of our calling system. We utilize this tool following a threat and even in a drill situation to inform parents and guardians of the activities and to let them know the status of the remainder of the day. This tool is very valuable as we attempt to reach the caregivers of our students. In our efforts to plan and prepare, and let me add, hopefully we hope never to have to act on them, I've asked emergency responders from the various locations around our county to meet with us to talk about protocol and response. We will continue to collaborate with safety and security professionals and will conduct what we call tabletop activities that will go beyond our school-based drills to help all those who are involved in an emergency response be well prepared to meet any need that exists. The topic itself is unsettling, but to deny it does not mean that it's not real. We are committed to the safety of our students, staff members, and the public who are in our schools and will continue to refine our planning practice and procedures to respond to a crisis event. For parents, we know that the fear is real and that the safety of your child is more important than anything else that we can do. The optimal learning environment is one that is safe, secure, and inviting. This is our goal for each school and classroom. I invite you to share any ideas that you have or any questions that you might have with me as we work together in preparing for something that we hope will never happen. I hope this would answer any questions, but at this time, if the board has any questions or comments that they'd like to make, I'll be glad to address them. I can't stress enough the work that we're doing, ongoing collaboration with law enforcement and emergency providers to try to stay on top of what we hope will be a situation we never deal with. Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you. Moving on to the discussion, no action.